Like most of our successful actors, Murray Bartlett got his start on Aussie soaps, including A Country Practice, Home and Away and Neighbours. In 2000, Murray relocated to the United States and is now a lead on the HBO series Looking. Murray is back home for Christmas and he's taken time out of his holidays to pay us a visit. Please welcome.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome home.
Thank you so much.
Is it great to be home?
It is. It's always good to come back. I love it here.
You've got the Aussie accent still.
I have. Yeah, I think I sort of adjust a little bit in America, but I've still kept it.
Good on you.
Well, what's it like in La La Land? We hear all these, you know, Australians go over, you know, next thing they know, they're riding in Humvees with Tom Cruise. Is it really...
It's certainly not my life. I actually live in New York, so it's
a lucky thing.
Yeah, it's a great city, and I feel like it's kind of a good way to have a little distance from the industry. Yeah. You know, kind of it feels a little more real in New York.
But you film in LA, do you?
No, we film in San Francisco.
Oh, do you?
Yeah,
nice.
Which is
nice. How nice.
It is. It's a beautiful city, and it actually has some similarities to Sydney, so it sort of it you know feels kind
like
of familiar.
It does. How does an Aussie actor who just goes cold to New America, where there's millions of actors, break into it?
I mean, I think everyone has a different path. I went to New York because I wanted to do some classes, some acting classes, and just get inspired. And I got there and fell in love with the city, just stayed a little bit longer, and then through a sequence of strange coincidences, got a great job there on Sex and the City. And then I got an agent out of that, and it kind of rolled along, you know.
Soaps have been a launching pad for a lot of our stars who have made it overseas. What is it about soaps that make you all? Is it the training? You become very versatile?
I think it's a great training ground for actors. You certainly get over your fear of learning lines because you have to learn so much in a short period of time.
And there you are in Neighbours.
Oh, my God.
That's from Neighbours, isn't
it?
Yeah.
Wow.
Does that feel like a long time ago?
It was a long time ago.
That bears a passing resemblance to a young Joe Hildebrand, I think.
Yes.
You know.
Yes. Is it true you almost gave up acting at one stage because you were so disillusioned?
I mean, I wasn't super disillusioned, but I think, you know, it's an unpredictable life. And I got to a point, I turned 40, and I was asking big questions about my life. And I was calling into question whether I wanted to have that unpredictable life. And then I had the opportunity to go to Egypt, which sort of took me out of the acting world for a while, and decided to do that. And it was during the whole revolution process in Egypt, completely shifted my perspective. And I came back raring to go. I was like, you know, I feel so lucky to have the life that I have. And it was great to step away and get a new perspective. But I at the end of that time, got the opportunity to work on Looking and, you know, threw
myself
into
it. As an actor, if you get a really successful show that's on television, you can really do quite well for yourself, can't you?
Absolutely, yeah. And I think, you know, one of the great things about television now is it's kind of having a heyday, you know. There's such fantastic programming, really great writing, and a lot of film actors now are kind of scrambling to work on TV, you know, so it's...
And you were really brave. You came out, which, you know, I suppose for an actor who doesn't want to be stereotyped, it must have been a very... Was there a lot of soul-searching with that?
I mean, I didn't... sort of technically come out. I just, if someone asked me if I was gay, I'd say yes. So there was, you know, there was thoughts in my mind about not wanting to be stereotyped as every actor has, I guess. But I didn't want to be dishonest. I didn't want to lie about my
life. Do you think it compromised the roles you were being offered, though?
It certainly hasn't yet. I'm so happy to be working on Looking.
Yeah.
I hope it won't. You always run that risk as an actor. You do a certain role and you can get sort of put into a pigeonhole. But I'm very happy with what I'm doing.
That's why I turned down James Bond.
Yeah.
A lot of people were devastated.
Murray, we always focus on people that have had extraordinary success, but like yourself, it can be a real battle to get a great job. What advice would you give Australians watching at home if they do want to follow their passion with acting? What's one piece of advice you'd give them?
I think ask yourself if it's something that you're really passionate about.
Yeah, right.
Because it's not easy. I mean, everyone has a different road, so some people find it easier than others. But if it's something that you're really passionate about, then you should just absolutely go for it and stay with it. You know, I've been fortunate. I've had some great jobs along the way, but there's been times when it's been very lean, yeah. and I have asked, you know, the big questions about, is this what I should be doing with my life? Should I be being a little more stable or something? But I've stuck with it, and I'm incredibly happy and incredibly grateful to have had the opportunities I've had. So I would say just be passionate and go for it and see
where
it takes you.
Follow your
passion.
Yeah. Very proud of you. Murray, congratulations on looking fantastic, and thank you for joining us.
Yeah, pleasure. Thanks so much.